by the time you buy this fragrance with your money, I won't be the one to tell you that you should not be spraying it every time. Hi guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Bella and this is Bella's Perfume Diaries. If this is your first time of stumbling on this channel, Perfume Diaries is a series where we talk about perfumes, a sprinkle of beauty and lifestyle. So if this is the kind of content you like, please click that subscribe button and join the family. And if you're a returning subscriber, welcome back. Thank you for tuning in once again. On today's episode, I'm going to be talking about a fragrance from the house of Nishane. Before we talk about the fragrance, I'm just going to do a quick backstory on the fragrance brand Nishane, just in case this is your first time of hearing of that brand. Nishane is the first and only Istanbul based niche perfume brand that is celebrated globally with an exceptional point of view on artistic perfumery. This can easily be recognized by the uniqueness of the scent creations, and I totally agree, Nishane perfumes are very unique. Nishane means mark and symbol. You can go ahead and read more about Nishane, but I agree that most of their fragrances are very unique, except for Hakchivat. I think that's how that one is pronounced. That fragrance smells very similar to Creed Aventus, which doesn't necessarily make it unique, but I have smelled Annie and I've smelled 100 Silent Ways, and I think they are somewhat unique. One of the fragrances that I have smelled and I would agree that is extremely unique is Annie, which I'm going to be talking about on this episode. So this is what the packaging of Annie by Nishane looks like. It comes in an outer purple pack. The inside of the pack is black, matte black, which is so pretty. I absolutely love this pack, and it has the Nishane logo here. It says Extra de Parfum, so this fragrance is an Extra de Parfum. When you slide it open, you see there's a card inside which has the Annie Nishane card, and then the notes of the fragrance are on the card as well. Typical niche packaging. I mean, if you're paying that much for a fragrance, of course they would have to, you know, put all the serenity inside. I'm quite impressed with this packaging. Inside the packaging is the bottle of the fragrance. It just sits in perfectly inside the pack. This is what Annie by Nishane bottle looks like. I got the 50 ml just because I wanted to test out the fragrance. This was a blind buy actually. I love the fact that the bottle looks very luxurious. I love the cap, it's quite heavy. I think most of their bottles come like this, but maybe different colors and all. This is not paper, by the way. I think it's rubber, I'm not so sure. So the main accords of this fragrance is warm, spicy, vanilla, woody, powdery, citrus, amber, aromatic, soft, spicy, balsamic and fruity. The fragrance is described as an amber floral fragrance for men and women, so this is totally unisex. The top notes are ginger, bergamot, pink pepper and green notes. Middle notes are cardamom, black currant and Turkish rose. Base notes are vanilla, benzoin, sandalwood, cedar, patchouli, ambergris and musk. This fragrance has a lot of notes in it, and you can tell when you smell it. This perfume is very unique. I have to give it that. It's extremely unique. I'll describe this fragrance as a green spicy fragrance with a sprinkle of vanilla. Before I got this fragrance, the hype on it made it seem like it was a vanilla dominant fragrance, but I was kind of taken back because it didn't give me what I expected. Just like I mentioned earlier, this was a blind buy, so I expected it to be a vanilla dominant fragrance, but this is not a vanilla dominant fragrance. Before you smell the vanilla, you smell the greenness, you smell the spiciness before the vanilla starts to come in. And it's not like your typical gourmand vanilla. This is more like a chocolate powdery vanilla. So this is a very luxurious fragrance. It smells very rich. It's not like easy to wear dumb rich fragrance. This fragrance, you wear it on special occasions. You don't wear it to just meet any kind of person. You wear it to meet important people. That's how expensive smelling and luxurious this fragrance smells. This fragrance is for special occasions only. By the time you buy this fragrance with your money, I won't be the one to tell you that you should not be spraying it every time. Like, special occasions alone. And just like you see, the dent on this is not so much, just because a little goes a long way. It's very strong, it's very long lasting, it projects crazy into the room. The first time I wore this fragrance, I oversprayed and I almost choked myself, like, because most times I overspray my fragrances, but then when I was oversprayed this, I almost fainted. It is really, really strong. It projects into the room. It's very unique. I don't have anything that smells like this in my collection at all. The first time I smelled this, I was like, no way. You know what? The first time I smelled this fragrance was when I was unboxing it. I was unboxing the fragrance on camera. So like, I did a whole ass unboxing video and put on my stories before my Instagram account was taken down. While I was unboxing, when I sprayed it, I paused. Because it wasn't what I was expecting. I wasn't happy with what I was smelling because I just felt like I expected vanilla and I wasn't getting vanilla. So I just felt like, oh my god, I need to sell this out ASAP. I don't like this at all. And then I just felt, okay, let me just give this like maybe a week wear or like 2 days wear and see if I still don't like it. And when I wore it, I just felt, okay, this is something that I can, you know, keep in my collection because it's quite unique and it smells very rich, expensive, luxurious. So I'm just like, you know what, I'm keeping this. And I'm so happy that I got a 50 ml, because I'm definitely not going to repurchase this, but I'm going to spray it sparingly just so it doesn't finish. So I have a love-hate relationship with this fragrance. I don't want it to finish, and at the same time I might not repurchase it. If you love green, spicy, rich, expensive smelling fragrances with a hint of vanilla, then you would absolutely love this. I think a guy would love this more, or a lady that loves masculine fragrances would love this more, but I don't love masculine fragrances, so this is like a love-hate fragrance. I don't like the fact that when people hide this fragrance, they made it seem like this was a vanilla dominant fragrance. So I would not see this fragrance as a blind buy worthy. It's not everybody that would like this fragrance. Major things I love in this fragrance is that luxurious feel that it gives, and it is quite unique, and it is not an offensive smelling fragrance. So I can see myself loving this, maybe obsessing over it in the future. So that is Annie by Nishani. Have you tried any fragrance from Nishani? Let me know in the comments which one is your favorite. Have you tried Annie? What do you think about it? Would you love to try it? Let me know in the comments. I'd love to connect with you in the comments section. Fortunately, we've come to the end of this video. Don't forget to like this video, drop a comment as well, subscribe if you haven't, share with your friends and family. Thank you guys for tuning in to Bella's Perfume Diaries. I'll be seeing you on my next episode. Bye.